Psst, we're giving away a White Octane at 90k subs, so subscribe. Speaking of black markets, if you're ever in need of black markets or any other Rocket League items, then you can check out our sponsor, RL Exchange. Let me run the ad. If you want an easy way to buy cheaper Rocket League items, no matter what console you're on, head over to RL Exchange and use code DILWOBS at checkout for 3% off. It's a super easy site to use, and there's a bunch of different payment methods that you can also use. And my favorite part is that they constantly run giveaways that you can enter by doing different tasks on the site. So make sure if you're buying things from RL Exchange, you also check out the giveaways tab, because I know you guys love your free items. So why not do that? There's a link in the description that will get you all set up, and hopefully you can enjoy buying some nice Rocket League items. Yo, what's going on guys, DeWobbs here, and welcome back to a brand new video here on the channel. Now in today's video, as you can see, we got a lot of black markets here in the inventory, because today I'll be showing you the top 10 black markets. Now what does that even mean? What does top 10 black markets mean? Well, let's not waste any time and let me show you what we're here to talk about in this video. So basically, there's a few different ways that you could categorize a black market, so I thought in this video, well, why not show you all of them? So what I'm going to show you first is the top 10 black markets in terms of price, because obviously more expensive black markets should be better because the community like them. So I'm going to first show you the top 10 non-painted black markets in terms of their price. I'm then going to show you the top 10 painted black markets in terms of price. Then after that, I will show you my top 10 list. So if you want to skip the prices thing and go to my top 10 list, which is fully based on sort of designs that you can make with them, then be my guest. I'll put a timestamp in the sort of, you know, the how the scroll bar has those timestamps now. That'll be there. Check it out. So starting off with the non-painted most expensive black market, it is indeed Interstellar. Now Interstellar is quite a new one, if I can find it on here. It is quite a new one, but honestly it does look really good, and I can see why it is the most expensive non-painted black market. It's really out there, and there's so many different sort of designs you can make with it. And a lot of YouTubers that I actually asked in one of my videos where I asked people's favorite decals, a lot of them said Interstellar, so it makes sense. The next one on the most expensive non-painted list is Mainframe. Now honestly, you'll see my opinions on Mainframe later on, but this is the next most expensive at 1,400 credits. Then Dissolver is in number 3 in terms of price, and that is 1,400 credits as well. As you can see, if you change the color, this is the sort of bit that changes color on there. Then in at number 4 at 1,400 credits again is the Stifflegate black market. Again, quite a new black market, and honestly, I love the look of this thing. It's so cool, and you can't change two colors. You can only change one color on this bad boy. Then in 5th place, again, the newest black market, the Exalta black market, as you can see, at 1,300 credits. Then in number 6, we have Tidal Stream, and that costs 1,000 credits. This one looks really bright and really funky. Then in at number 7, we have Heatwave. Now, Heatwave is such an OG, a very, very classic. Look at that. Honestly, you can't go wrong with Heatwave. And that's 900 credits, so it's come down from its old days. Then we have Fire God at 800 credits. As you can see, sort of Heatwave 2.0. Then at number 9, we have 20XX at 650 credits. Look at that, the regular 20XX there. Such a wacky decal. And then in at number 10, you have Stormwatch, which costs 600 credits. So that is in terms of price. Now that sort of says what the community likes in terms of unpainted black markets. Now let me show you the list of the top 10 most expensive painted black markets. Number 1, we have Grey Mainframe. And if you didn't know, that's because it's a discontinued item. So it's super rare, and that's why people pay so much for it. Then at number 2, you have White Mainframe. Then at number 3, we have White Slipstream, one of the OG black markets that now comes painted. Then at number 4, we have Black Slipstream. Then at number 5, we have Crimson Slipstream. Number 6 is Purple Slipstream. 7 is Sky Blue Slipstream. 8 is Black Mainframe. 9 is Cobalt Slipstream. And 10 is Pink Slipstream. Yep, so the top 10 painted list for black markets is literally just painted mainframes and painted slipstreams, so it's a very boring list, if I'm honest. But now on to the fun part, the part of the video that I hope most of you came here for, my top 10 list of black markets. Now please do not hate in the comments. If you disagree, that is perfect, because it means that you can comment down below your top 10 black markets in terms of appearance, and then we can sort of see what people's favorite black markets are. And I think everyone deserves their own opinion, but if you want any advice on what black markets to buy, then you could use this list if you want to. So in at number one, actually, let's go from 10th up to first for my list so that the last one is sort of, you know, the absolute whopper. So in at number 10, I have gone with the Tidal Stream black market. And the reason this one makes the top 10 is primarily because of how bright it is. I mean, you don't have loads of customizability because the accent color can barely be seen at the back there, but it still does that sort of hint that it gives of that accent color is enough. I think it makes a really nice car design. But obviously, as you can see, look how flipping bright your car gets. If you choose any of these bright colors, I mean, look at that gold as well. But look, choosing these bright colors like this pink right here, your car is never getting brighter than this. Tidal Stream really does show off how bright Rocket League colors can get. I mean, look at that. Look at this front part of the car here. It is literally glowing. And that is why Tidal Stream makes it in at number 10. Now, in at number 9, I've gone with the Riser decal, and honestly, I think this is a really funky one. Now, there are a lot of people outside my window right now. It's sunny in the UK. They're enjoying their time out there, so if you can hear a bit of background noise, don't worry. It's just people enjoying the sun. But anyway, back to the Riser decal. If you didn't know, this was a tournament reward and it's untradeable. So if you don't have it, I am sorry. However, if you're on PC, you can use Backer's Mod to sort of get any decals you want and put them on your car. But the reason I've chose Riser to be number 9 in this case is because I really like how funky it is and I like how much it pops. This sort of black sort of texture in the middle, I think it goes really well. And I think it separates two colors very nicely. For example, red and blue. Look how funky this looks right here. Now, obviously, the white octane makes it pop even more, but I just love this kind of look. Being able to separate two colors, it means you can sort of mix two colors that go really well together. For example, pink and purple. Or, for example, pink and lime. Look at that. Having that black divider in the middle means you choose two really bright contrasting colors. This thing looks stunning. I mean, it doesn't stop there. Purple and orange, I'm sure. Look how nice this looks. I've got all the color combinations in the bag, and the Riser decal really helps make them stand out. And that's why it makes number 9. Honestly, it could be higher, if I'm honest. But the fact that it's not tradable, I think it has to stay down here at number 9. Then at number 8, I have to put Bubbly on here. Now, the reason Bubbly's not higher is because Bubbly doesn't go as bright as I'd like it. I wish Bubbly was a little more vibrant, sort of this middle area right here. I wish it wasn't sort of so unsaturated. Otherwise, Bubbly would be super high up. But what I really like, I think, these days with Bubbly is using a dark accent color because it just makes it look a bit better. Like, if you use a light accent color, do you see what I mean? It's kind of unsaturated. However, sometimes that is a really, really good look, depending on what wheels you can choose. But I've always liked the Bubbly decal. Look at that. That is a classic look right there. The Sprite car design. That's what I like to call this one. So Bubbly is an OG, and it makes it to number 8. Then at number 7, I'm actually putting Stormwatch. Now, you guys might disagree that Bubbly and Stormwatch might need to switch around here. But honestly, I really like using Stormwatch. And not so much these days. I don't really use it as much these days. I go with sort of simpler car designs. However, I was a big user of Stormwatch for a while. But I really like doing this kind of look. Just an orange and then a lighter orange. Or the same with blue, using a dark blue and then sort of a lighter blue. I think this just looks really, really clean on your car. Now, put that with some Hypnotic wheels or something like that, and you have yourself a super nice car design. Really, really clean looking, and I just like how the gradient goes from sort of the main dark primary color to the light part of the primary color. This fade just looks really satisfying. No matter what color you choose, it really does pull it off well. So I really like that with the Stormwatch. And yeah, you guys can argue as much as you want. I think Stormwatch is still a really nice decal. Then in at number 6, it's gonna be the Stipplegate because, I mean, just look how different this is. It's such an out there black market. Now, usually people don't like black markets where you don't get two colors with, for example, Biomass and Labyrinth. But I think Stipplegate really does show off how you can use a black color in Rocket League to make your car just look so freaking awesome. I mean, look at this. Obviously, any color you choose will look good with this car. I like choosing colors that are really vibrant though, because then you get that pearlescent glow as you turn your car, But obviously, you can make so many really, really try-hard looking car designs with this. Get some black Daichis involved, and we've got a whole nother story. But I just love how original this decal is. Look at it from above there. I mean, you're not going to see a car this black on Rocket League with anything else, are you? It's such a cool black market. And this pattern here, sort of glitching around, looks really good as well. It looks like when birds, like all of them together, you've probably seen on some David Attenborough documentary how the birds sort of do dances in the air. That's what it always reminds me of, and I think it looks really, really fascinating. Then in at number 5, we have ourselves the Dissolver black market. I can't not put Dissolver high up. I mean, everybody seems to love Dissolver, and honestly, I can see why. It is a very vibrant and nice looking black market. Some colors I think don't work at all with Dissolver, but some colors do. Like these two colors right here work nicely. But again, what I really like to do with Dissolver is choose two blue colors like this. Look at that. And basically that turns the Dissolver black market into a water black market. It is literally just a swimming pool. I mean, look at this car. And that's why Dissolver gets up to number 5 on the list. Simply because you can do this with it. I really love it. It was one of the first things I found when Dissolver came out, and honestly, I've never forgotten this. It's such a nice looking car. Obviously, pair that with some shark wheels, a Toon Hydro Trail, and you're off. Then, in at number 4, I've gone with Slipstream. Now, personally, I was a bit stuck on what to put here. I wasn't gonna put Slipstream really anywhere at first, but then I started looking at the painted versions, and I started realizing, you know what? They're actually pretty cool. So the reason it goes this high up on the list is because it's an old classic black market. But now finally, Rocket League have allowed them to become painted. So it has to be high up on the list because there's so many different colors that make this thing look cool. And honestly, I probably haven't found the perfect Slipstream car design yet, but I'm sure it's waiting for someone to find. 3 colors can be used on this black market. And if you guys have been on the channel for a while, you know, I love me some 3-color combination car design, so the Slipstream definitely will make it to number 4. Then at number 3, I've had to go with Interstellar just because it is the black market that everybody wanted. Before it came out, everybody thought, what black markets do we want? And we always got sort of simplistic kind of cartoonish sort of black markets, but I feel like everybody always wanted a literal, just literally deep space to just get whacked on your car. It's like, think about it. I'm pretty sure in Fortnite, there's a galaxy skin. In Call of Duty, there's definitely a skin out there that is like, kind of like this. And a lot of games have used that, but Rocket League were yet to do it until the Interstellar decal came out. And it blew us all away because of how different it looks. Like, let me just show you some different ones. Heatwave, look at that. That does look like it's something on a car. Intrudium, that looks like it's something on a car. Mainframe, it looks like it's something on a car. Bam, Interstellar, it doesn't even look like it should be on a car. It looks like you're just looking into a whole nother universe. And that's why it's so out there and so different. I feel like everybody still loves a good bit of Interstellar. Then at number 2, I'm going with Heatwave because it is an OG, literally the best black market from back in the day. I'm telling you, this thing looks amazing. I mean, look at this. There's so many different colors you can go with this, but I love putting the accent color on black because it feels like a whole different decal. If I make the accent white, as you can see, it looks so, so nice, and these fire lines are super bold. But if I put it on black, those lines become a lot thinner, and it genuinely feels like a whole new black market, and I love this look. So if you've never done this with Heatwave, get yourself a white car. It could be a white Fennec, a white Octane, a white Dominus, a white this, a white that. I mean, to be fair, most of you probably have the white Fennec now because it was in the item shop a load of times. So you can definitely make this car design, but with the white Fennec. And that is why I love the Heatwave. It's so nice. And the fact that it's still one of the nicest black markets, in my opinion, after we've had so many new black markets, it's number 2 on the list. But what is number 1 on my list, guys? It's 20XX. And why is it 20XX? Well, if you've been watching the channel in 2021, you've probably seen me with a car design that looks a little something like this. I love this thing. This is probably my, this is my car design. I feel like this car design, I rock it all the time. And yeah, it's my car design. I'm going to claim it as my own. Okay, I'm not claiming it as my own. There are definitely other people out there that have definitely done this before because it looks so freaking nice. The orange painted 20XX with a purple primary color and an orange accent. I mean, I just love this thing. But also, not only that, I just love painted 20XXs in general. They look really nice. And you can make so many car designs that look just as good as this. But not only that, 20XX is also affordable in different painted versions. It never goes over like 2,000 credits. Now, some of you might be thinking that's crazy, but for a painted black market, honestly, 20XX is a good price. But also, the non-painted 20XX is the most original black market I think we've ever seen. Look at this thing. You can't even guess what color is gonna come out of it. The way these colors mix makes no sense, and that's why I love it. If I put red and blue, it's just wacky. If I put pink and, I don't know, that orange color, where's the orange in that? Oh, there it is. Oh, why is there green in there and blue and all these colors? I don't know, but I love it. That is what I love about 20XX. It's so different to any other black market. It always will be. And I think there's a reason that consoles used to use 20XX as their price guides. Yep, if you're a free-to-play player, let me tell you something. Basically, on console, you never used to be able to trade keys. So what did people use as price guides? What did people use as currencies? They used 20XX as a currency. So 20XX had a price, and then people based other items' prices off how many 20XXs you'd use to get it. So let's say there was an item that wasn't that valuable, it will be worth 0.2 20XX. Or if you had an item that's really, really rare, that's worth 10XX, that means it's 10 lots of 20XX. How cool is that? It had its own currency. So that is why the 20XX takes the dub in my books. I think it looks super, super nice. And yeah, you've probably seen me rocking this car design. It was in my tryhard car designs video and everybody loved it. And I love it as well. So that is my top 10 black markets on Rocket League. Hopefully the video wasn't too long and you could just enjoy looking at different black markets and hearing what I had to say about them. But what I want to do is hear what you have to say about them. So comment down below your top 10 black markets and I'll be sure to read them all. I'll see you in the next one, guys. Goodbye.